And for our discussion tonight, we're joined here in the studio by College of Law Dean Ernest Maceda of the Pamantasan ng Lunsod ng Maynila.
Now, you can be part of this discussion by sending us your comments and questions through Twitter using the hashtag PrimeTime or post them on our Facebook page. That's ANC247. Good evening, Dean. Tony?
Dean, thanks very much for joining us.
Always a pleasure.
You know, first of all, you know, like the president, the Chief Justice has this issue, you know, sort of like hovering over her head, and it's about her psychiatric evaluation. You know, remember the president, right?
It's always dangerous to talk about psychiatric stress in connection with our high government officials. Yeah. But in this case, it's a hovering issue which has not been
confirmed. Yeah, it's a leak, but not verified. No, but so that being the case, should people know what her psychiatric evaluation is? Because we actually saw the JBC interviews live. That was open to the public. Now, should we go a step further and know what the psychiatric evaluation or score of the Chief Justice nominees are and of the Chief Justice herself?
All right. There are two sides to that, because the lower or lesser employees or officials of government, and even in the private sector, are normally required to undergo psychiatric tests. You know? But when you speak of these other high offices, sasabihin naman ng iba, wala namang requirement na ganyan. Ano? Now, when these psychiatric tests were taken, I think they were done under the guise of being confidential and privileged. And I don't think that there's any reason for us now to go into that, especially since there is nobody, is anybody making an issue of it? Is there something supposedly psychiatrically wrong with
the issue there is whether it was leaked out. An investigation is going to be conducted, but still in the end, the JBC is saying, yeah, we're not confirming whether that score of four is real.
Well, those tests were really just to help them in assessing. No? In fact, none of us have any idea of what manner of testing was conducted. Malay mo, it was just,
question and answer.
Question and answer also. Or
what's your favorite color? It's like a Rorschach ink blot test. What do you see there?
We asked that question because we heard also that according to the JBC rules, none of those in the short list should none of those candidates should be part of the short list if their score in the psychiatric exam falls between 4 and 5.
All right.
And if it's 4 and 5, then you're definitely out of the short list. That's what we heard, but we don't know if that score is indeed true, because of no one has confirmed the leak or verified, as Tony said.
And would the JBC actually recommend a name in the short list if indeed the psychiatric score was 4 or 5?
Well, the best response to that is, since we don't know, let's not talk about it first.
But really, I mean, given that process, you know, you have a psychiatric appraisal or evaluation, you give a score or assign a score, does it honestly actually show you something about the candidate who becomes the Chief Justice? Does it give you a picture, really, of how this person will perform once in office?
Well, if it at all does give you a measure, it's probably just one of the several that you're supposed to look at.
Okay. And not the most critical.
Not the most critical, unless, you know, unless there's really, you know, not just a hint, but she's widely or he's widely perceived or known to, you know, be lacking something up there.
Because remember how they used it against the president during the campaign, right?
Yeah, of course. But, you know, that's when you speak of elective office, it's really more vicious and all that. No, right here, when you're choosing someone, and you have marami kang pamantayan, yung husay niya, yung tinapos niya, etc., etc., dapat isa lang yan.
Okay. And it doesn't outweigh all the other factors.
Yeah, it should not be controlling. Yeah. Yes.
Well, anyway, we got a sense of how Chief Justice Sereno would like to work with her colleagues now in the judiciary, in the Supreme Court. She made that impassioned appeal to the employees. Kalimutan muna natin yung mga intriga, diba? Isang tabi muna natin yung mga away-away. I mean, obviously, she's coming from the point where she knows there are a lot of people who are supportive of Chief Justice Corona, and they may just be hostile to whoever replaced him, right?
Yes.
Is there any reason or cause for concern for Justice Sereno taking over now that she has to make that appeal?
Well, her selection was really, you know, out of the box. It defied tradition. It was against precedent. So if she is experiencing this now, she should not be surprised, no? But rather, she should look at this as really an opportunity or as a challenge for her to show that, you know, well, this I am the person selected, and you're stuck with me, but I'm going to show you that I'm, you know.
Hey, stuck with me for 18 years.
Sabi nga no iba,
they'll be retired before she does.
That's right. The president was whining, sabi no iba, about how GMA, you know, tinanggal sa kanya yung pagkakataon na magtalaga ng sarili niyang choice. But he turns around and does it to the next three presidents. That's one way to look at it, of course.
Yeah, okay.
But then how much do you think of her time should the new Chief Justice now devote to keeping the unity again and fostering goodwill among those whom she perceives as hostile?
You know, upon your appointment as Chief Justice, your caseload as a justice is actually reduced to 30% of what you're actually used to, in recognition of the manifold duties that the CJ holds. No? So because of that, she is given the opportunity to be, aside from primus inter pares of her fellow equal justices, she's the head of the Judiciary, 2,000 judges, 26,000 employees, head of the IBP, all the lawyers in the country. She's the premier academic, head of the PhilJA. Ang daming trabaho eh. And she has already attacked a couple of them, being the head of the administrative head and financial head of the Supreme Court. She's already attending to that, no? And so I think right now, she, whether she should devote her time to this, she is already doing it.
No, but should she like still reach out or just hit the ground running? And
in her first public statement at the POLA, Presidents of Law Associations, no, she said that dialogue is the key.
Yeah.
No, to reform, meaning dialogue with her fellow justices or fellow judges. So sabi niya, I will reach out. But come Monday, hindi pa rin yata naka-reach out, no? Because I think the senior justices didn't get the memo.
Yan nga, magsasabihin ko sana din, mahirap ata mag-reach out sa wala. Because most of the senior justices weren't present during the flag-raising ceremony. Now, what does that tell you?
Well, it just shows us that the Chief Justice will have a bumpy first few months. It is in this sense that we feel we as citizens should give our support to her. No, you know, a lot of people within the legal profession, within the judiciary, are already going to be giving her a hard time. No? But since she is there already as the selected Chief Justice of the President, and in theory our own choice, because it's our President who chose her, then as much as we can, let's try to give her, cut her some slack.
Well, just how much slack will she get from her colleagues?
She's not getting any slack from, sino ba yung nakita natin, yung Employees Association, you know, we're very critical.
Yeah, yeah.
Yung colleagues. But, you know, she looks like she's a fighter. Based on, we were talking about her responsibilities as a Chief Justice administratively. But as a jurist, matapang si Chief Justice Sereno. Because from day one, she was always with Justice Carpio in the dissent, as against the majority decisions which President Aquino felt was against him, no?
Yeah.
And her dissents, her decisions, ponentias were always very lucid. Mm-hmm. You know, the basis for her decisions were very clear, and they were fearless.
Mm-hmm.
So, in fact,
as fearless as her minority or dissenting opinion on the valuation of the Hacienda Luisita shares.
You're the one fearless here.
but that's an issue, actually.
Yeah, that's an issue
Twitter,
for some
right?
people.
Because
also.
It actually said, you know, you're showing your yellow collar right here, uh-huh. right? And people were wary about, you know, thinking that she could be as independent as any Chief Justice is expected to
no,
be.
No, but here's the thing, you know, when you are Chief Justice, and if you want to succeed, and knowing that, you know, in a few years' time, President Aquino will no longer be here, I think it's really the dynamics of the institution that ultimately your loyalty will really belong to the institution more rather than to anyone who appointed you or somebody outside.
Mm-hmm. In theory.
Because that's how you're going to be judged. Are you a good Chief Justice? That you will be judged as a good Chief Justice if you can show that you can lead the court properly, mm-hmm. if your decisions are sound, etc. You're not going to be judged as a good Chief Justice if you are a good soldier of Malacañang. Mm-hmm. That's the worst case that way that you can be judged.
Of course. Now, in previous interviews, people in the business community were saying that because of Chief Justice Sereno's background, having been the executive director of the Asian Institute of Management, that she would actually do well or perform well in perhaps settling issues regarding maybe business cases, no? Mm-hmm. Do you see anything that might come her way that she would actually have an opportunity to prove that expectation?
Well, right now I'm not. There's so many. There's so many on the horizon. I can't think of one immediately that comes to mind.
Coco Levy, wala na.
Pero sinasabi kasi nila, like just the other day, you had a guest here at Head Start, no? Si Attorney Sardillo, no? Mm. I don't know if they're going to revisit that. Naturally, they're going to. It might come up, but then again, there's the specter of the flip flop coming into play. Mm-hmm. No. What's more interesting for me is yung statement niya in her speech na, you know, she owes it to God, and then Senator Arroyo reacted, etc. But, you know, there was a concern kasi on the part of the CBCP that perhaps her loyalty to Malacañang might affect her position when it comes to the RH bill. So, how do you reconcile that? She's very religious.
So, you're going to get, your expectation is the RH bill
will reach the
all the way to the Supreme Court.
Oh, definitely. If it passes, no? Yeah. It will reach the Supreme Court. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, everything lands on the
Supreme
Court.
Very interesting.
And how do you mentioned Senator Arroyo there. This is the exact quote that he said. He said, because Chief Justice Sereno said that it's God's will that she's here, to which the senator said, we hope that she doesn't think that way because that is not good. That does not allow for dissent.
But you know what? I don't know. Senator Joker Arroyo, having questioned whatever Chief Justice Sereno said about her being in that position because of divine will. Mm. Remember, very first month of President Arroyo, before the May 1 uprising, she was also saying that it was divine will that brought her to Malacañang. I didn't hear Senator Arroyo question that then.
No, and I don't know if it was Senator Arroyo who, during the impeachment of Chief Justice Corona, said that the Chief Justice we need should be more
pious.
Popish than the Pope.
Mm.
And of course, they weren't referring to, you know, him speaking ex cathedra, being infallible. Mm. But obviously, Senator Arroyo took it that way. It's dangerous for you to be spouting this.
Yeah.
Yes.
If you're the Chief Justice.
If you're the Chief Justice.
Yeah.
There's so many and so many levels because separation of church and state, the RH bill.
Certainly.
Now, we do know that one of the major problems of the judiciary, Tony and Dean, is the funding or the lack of it.
Mm-hmm.
But I think it's tomorrow, no less than the budget secretary himself will pay a visit to the Supreme Court and hopefully thresh out some of these
issues. What do you think
issues.
Of that?
No, I was going to ask you that. What do you think of that? Is that unprecedented? Is it, you know, alagang-alaga ba si Chief Justice?
Or yes,
ano ba?
You know, even if I were a member of the judiciary, whether as a jurist or as an employee, I'd welcome that because it would resolve once and for all because right now it's under a cloud. But on the question of independence, like you know, for me, I think what's important here is that the Chief Justice be clear on her sensitivity to the issue of, you know, the distribution of powers. It's not just whether she's a good academic, it's not just whether she's a good jurist, but whether she knows that, you know, or she is conscious of the fact that as head of the Supreme Court, she's now, kumbaga, defending the turf, eh, no? And when you have the executive, as you said, babying you like that, there's always going to be, diba, the view na, hey, maybe independence here is being compromised in one way or the other.
Because that's the point, right? I mean, this is my old question, and we were discussing this before we went on there. Yeah. I mean, how can you be construed to be independent of the executive branch when it's the head of that branch that appointed you there in the first place? And then it's the executive branch that decides just how much funding you get in your 2013 budget.
Yes, but you know, the originally that was designed to be the executive and the legislative, because dumadaan dati yan sa commission and appointments, and it was all just part of the entire checks and balance
checks and
process.
Balances.
Yes,
but now that's major because of the JBC replacing the CA.
So it's a good thing. I mean, you have the Supreme Court Chief Justice who's on good footing with the executive branch, and they sort of. You know, feel that they deserve that kind of budgetary support. Why complain, right? I mean, why find anything sinister?
Because people will say, okay, the Chief Justice is close to Malacañang and cooperating, and you know, which would be good for the judiciary. But it's a Chief Justice; it's not the institution itself, you know. And that's always how these things should be measured, because she is, after all, part of the institution
and not the institution itself.
Yes.
Well, so a Chief Justice doesn't deserve a honeymoon period, just like the President?
Well, the President was... Well, the President replaces somebody who was elected and who had an entire term, and there is, so to speak, a curve, no? Where this should not really exist in the case of Chief Justice Sereno, she having already been there, no? And she's coming into a situation where there is really a gaping wound that needs healing, as some justices would say. So I don't think, as the Employees Association said, sana she doesn't take too much time, no? Because they really need this reform. Also, to reform the sorry state they're in as an institution among themselves.
Yep. Supposedly, one of the reforms already put in place, the adoption of the judicial affidavits.
Yeah, that, you know, that
to take the place of direct examination.
That speeds up the process a lot.
Yeah. Well, but it's not supposed to be to her credit, right? Because it was already being implemented
before.
In other courts. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and that's really the baby of Senior Associate Justice Carpio and Justice Abad. But it's still the entire court, as I said. It's the institution that passed it.
All right. Dean Ernst Maceda, thanks very much for coming.
Thank you, Tony.
Thank you.
Thank you, Carmine.
Thank you.
Okay.